force. Force is defined as a push or pull that makes an object move. Force is applied to put a stationary object into motion by increasing its speed, or to stop a moving object by decreasing its speed. Force is also applied to change the shape of an object. When you write, for example, you are exerting a force on the pencil because you push it over the paper. In this picture, both the men are moving the trolley in the same direction, although one is pulling and the other is pushing it, which helps them move it faster. Two forces applied on the same object and in the same direction will make the work easier and faster. On the other hand, if both the men pull the trolley in the opposite direction, the trolley will remain at its place or will move in the direction of the force applied by the stronger person. The game of tug of war is based on this principle. The team which can apply more force wins the game, as it overcomes the force applied by the weaker team and finally pulls it towards them. Force requires the presence of minimum two interacting bodies. The effect of force is seen by the change in the direction or motion or shape or position of an object to which it is applied. Types of forces. Sir Isaac Newton experimented and explained the science of movement through his three laws of motion. First law: an object in motion will remain in motion, and an object at rest will remain at rest unless an external force acts on it. Second law: acceleration of an object increases as the amount of force causing the acceleration increases. The greater the mass of an object, the greater will be the force required to accelerate it. Third law: for every action, there is an equal and opposite reaction. Gravitational force. The force of the Earth pulls all objects down towards it. This downward pull of the Earth is called the force of gravity. Whenever you throw anything in the air with a force which is more than the force of gravity, it will initially go upwards. But as soon as it loses this extra force, gravity pulls it down. Gravity is acting upon every object, whether moving or at rest. It keeps us and all other objects from floating in space. Gravity is present not only on Earth, but also on the Moon and other planets, though the amount of pull differs everywhere. The Moon's gravity is 1/6 that of the Earth. Gravity is the force that holds the universe together. All the planets are kept in their orbits because of the gravitational pull of the Sun. Each planet revolves so quickly around the Sun that the Sun's gravity cannot pull the planet towards itself. Yet, the planets do not revolve so fast that they can break away from the Sun's pull and hurtle off into space. Gravity is the force of attraction between all masses. There is gravitational attraction even between two persons sitting next to each other, but that force is far too small to have an impact. the more mass things have, and the closer they are, the stronger is the gravitational pull between them. The idea that all masses attract each other is called Newton's law of gravitation. Magnetic force. A magnet is not sticky like glue or sellotape, yet objects made of iron and steel stick to it. All magnets have a north pole and a south pole. A north pole and a south pole will always attract each other. But two north poles and two south poles will always repel each other. When a piece of magnet is hanged from a piece of thread, it always turns in a north-south direction. This is because of the Earth's magnetic field. Magnetic materials are those which are attracted to magnets and can be magnetized, that is, made into magnets. The metals iron, nickel, and cobalt are strongly magnetic. Some alloys, that is, mixtures containing these metals, are strongly magnetic too. Steel contains a lot of iron, so it acts as a strong magnet. Remember, not all types of steel can be magnetized. Kitchen utensils made of stainless steel have very less content of iron and hence cannot be used for this purpose. Let us do an activity. Take a steel rod and place it on a table. Label it AB. Place one of the poles of a bar magnet over end A of the steel rod. Without lifting the bar magnet, move it along the length of the steel rod till its other end B. Lift the bar magnet, bring the same pole to end A of the steel rod, and then move the magnet from end A to end B again. Repeat this several times. Now bring the steel rod near a few paper clips. The steel rod attracts the paper clips. Your steel rod is magnetized. Electrostatic force. When some materials are rubbed, they become charged with static electricity. This charge produces forces. This kind of force is called electrostatic force. Experiments with a comb and ruler show the effects of electrostatic forces, but these forces play a far greater role in the world, in fact, in the universe. It is these forces which hold the atoms together to form all the materials around us and within us. Friction. Frictional force is the force that acts between a moving object and the surface along which it moves. The force of friction acts opposite to the direction of motion. It plays an important role in our daily lives. We are able to walk because of the frictional force between our foot soles and the ground. It is difficult to walk on smooth, slippery ground or if the ground is greasy or oily. This is because the presence of oil or grease reduces the frictional force between the ground and our shoes. If there was no frictional force between the paper and the pen or pencil, we would not have been able to write, paint and draw anything. Rough surfaces generate more friction. If you look through a very powerful microscope, you will notice that even those surfaces which we call smooth are actually quite rough. Smoother surfaces offer less friction. Rolling objects have lesser friction than sliding objects. Friction acts everywhere. However, it has its disadvantages. Friction causes heat. This heat can cause damage to engine parts. So, coolants are put in vehicle engines. Friction causes wear and tear of machine parts. This is reduced by keeping ball bearings lubricated with oil. Ball bearings roll against each other instead of rubbing, so friction is less. Remember, friction between the tectonic plates causes earthquakes. Work is said to be done when a force moves something in the direction of the force applied. We apply force to get our daily chores done. In terms of energy, work is done when energy is transferred from one object to the other object by applying force. For example, work is done when a ball is kicked and set in motion. This work is done by the force applied to kick using muscular energy. Man has developed various machines with the aim of getting maximum work done with minimum use of force and energy.
Energy. Energy can be defined as the ability to do work. For any kind of action to take place, energy is required. Even something as simple as breathing or the blinking of eyelids requires energy. Energy can neither be created nor destroyed. Energy simply changes its form from one kind to another. Living things need food as fuel for energy to do different activities. We all need energy to run around, to play, jump, dance, and even study. People doing hard physical work like construction workers, salesmen, delivery boys, etc. need a lot more energy than others. Cars and vehicles are non-living things and require energy in the form of fuel to move. Energy is of utmost importance in everything. Right from drying clothes on a clothesline to sending astronauts into space.
Forms of energy. Energy exists in many forms: chemical, mechanical, heat, light, sound, electrical, and magnetic energy are some forms of energy. Energy can easily change from one form to another. Let us observe this in case of potential and kinetic energy. Potential energy is the energy stored in an object because of its position. The position gives it the ability to do work in the future. Look, as soon as the ball is dropped, the potential energy is converted into kinetic energy. Kinetic energy is the energy that an object has because of its
motion.
If each one of us is careful in preserving energy, in whatever little way we can, it will be for our own good.
Chemical energy. Food, fuels, and batteries contain chemical energy. This form of energy is released when chemical reactions take place. Some foods have lots of concentrated energy. Most packaged foods have the energy values printed on the packet. Fuels like petrol, coal, and natural gas have energy which is released on burning. Vehicle engines use this to produce motion. Batteries have energy which make clocks, some toys, and mobiles work. Electrical energy. When we plug in a battery, the electrical energy moves through the wire and charges the stored chemical energy in the battery. The same thing happens when we switch on any electric appliance. Heat, thermal energy. Everything is made of atoms. When a solid or liquid is heated, the atoms start vibrating at a faster pace, releasing energy in the form of heat. Heat always refers to the transfer of energy between objects and not to the energy contained within the object. When you plug in an iron and put the switch on, the electrical energy is transferred to the iron and that produces heat. This heat releases the potential energy in the iron, and when you move that iron over your shirt, the heat is transferred from the iron to the shirt. Sound energy. Sound refers to anything that can be heard, whether it is made by speaking or by striking a note on a guitar or by dropping a stone in water. Sounds also help us to communicate. They are produced when something vibrates or shakes. Let's see how. The vibrations make the air shake and the shaking air enters our ears, which we hear as a sound. Solar energy. Radiant light and heat energy produced by the sun is called solar energy. This energy is vital for the survival of living things on Earth. Additionally, this energy is now being harnessed to create electricity and heat to run gadgets and appliances. Many people get solar panels fitted onto the roofs of their houses that trap the solar energy and convert it into electrical energy to light up their homes as well as run ACs and fans.
Hundreds of solar cells are joined together to form a solar panel. Each solar cell generates a tiny electric current when hit by light. The bigger the solar panel, the more electrical energy it can generate. There is no fear of this solar energy getting exhausted. It will always be there. And the most important fact is, it is non-polluting.
Nuclear energy. A fuel is something that produces heat when treated in a certain manner. Most fuels give out heat when they burn. However, nuclear fuel gives out heat without burning. In a nuclear power plant, the nuclear energy is obtained by breaking down heavy metals like uranium, thorium, plutonium, etc. When a nuclear fuel is broken down, it generates heat. This heat can be used to generate electricity.
What is a machine? A machine is a device that makes work simpler, easier, and faster. Machines reduce time, effort, and energy to do work. Simple machines are those that have a simple structure and work on a simple and basic principle. Look at some commonly used simple machines. For a machine to function, force needs to be applied at a convenient point. Different kinds of simple machines. There are 6 kinds of simple machines used by us in our daily lives. The pulley, the inclined plane, the screw, the wedge, the lever, the wheel, and the axle. Pulley. The pulley helps us in lifting loads vertically by applying force in a suitable and convenient direction. It consists of a wheel which is fixed to a support. The wheel has a grooved rim over which a rope is passed. The load is tied to one end of the rope and the effort is applied at the other end of the rope. It is very difficult to lift a weight upwards against the force of gravity. But through a pulley, we pull down instead of pulling up, and thus less effort is required. Inclined plane. An inclined plane is a flat surface with a slope. When we place a plane, that is, plank or rod, etc., at an angle to the base of a surface, it becomes an inclined plane. This is used especially when heavy things have to be loaded or unloaded. Using an inclined plane makes the work much easier as relatively small force is needed. It is easier to push something up a slope rather than lifting it straight up. Lever. A lever is a simple machine. The man is using an iron rod to lift the heavy package. He has placed a block of wood close to the package and he is resting the rod on it. He applies a downward force and thus is able to lift the package. Here, the iron rod is the lever. The package to be lifted is the load. The wooden block is the fulcrum, also called a pivot, which is the fixed point of the lever. The force which the man is using to lift the package is known as the effort. There are 3 kinds of levers with different arrangements of load, effort, and fulcrum. First class lever. Load, fulcrum, effort.
the effort put at one end of the rod is transferred to the other end of the rod, which is pushed under the load, and the work gets done. Here, the fulcrum is between the load and the effort. Second class liver. Fulcrum, load, effort. In these types of livers, the fulcrum is at one end, the effort is applied at the other end, and the load is in between. Therefore, the load is between the fulcrum and the effort. Third class liver. Fulcrum, effort, load. In the third kind of liver, the effort is between the load and the fulcrum. A screw. A screw is a modified version of an inclined plane. It is actually an inclined plane in a circular form. It is a sharp pointed metal pin with a thread wound around it. It has a slotted head. It is used to join or hold things together by being rotated under pressure. Water is sometimes lifted from a river to irrigate a field with a device called Archimedes' screw. Each time the screw turns, it lifts water a little bit higher up inside a tube. It was a commonly used device in Egypt. The common nuts and screws used for fixing parts of engines and machinery work together in the same way.
Screws are used to attach a hinge to the frame of the door and the door. The hinge holds the door and the frame together. The screw holds the hinge.
Wheel and axle. The wheel on its axle is another example of a simple machine.
An axle is the rod to which the wheels are connected.
When you turn the handle of an egg whipper, the egg whips slowly. It moves the wheel at a greater speed. The axle transmits this turning motion to the blades, which in turn rotate fast to do their job.
The wheel is larger than the axle. The axle turns in a smaller circle, but with a greater force.
Wedge. A wedge is a sharp-edged object having a special shape which helps us in piercing or cutting an object or material.
The wedge is a special kind of inclined plane. Place two inclined planes back to back and we get a wedge.
Axe, knife, sickle, saw, and needle are examples of wedge.
When force is applied to the thick end of the wedge, that force gets transferred to the thin end. That pressure is enough to cut the object into its pieces.